and the girl who loves the sea. It calls me.
Ngiyanibingelela bantwana bedlozi, ngiyabingelela bantwana bezinzuza. Lo part 2 we video le ekhuluma ngokuthi Dlozi Child, Nzuza Child. La engangibeke khona ukuba careless and nakho kunye kangikubikile ngase ngathi ke okunye kusazolandela ngenze upart 2 wakhona. So iwona ke part 2 waleyo video ke lo. Confusion between alignment and spiritual cleansing. Okay, let's just talk about that because abantwana bedlozi abaningi they are confused between alignment ne cleansing. Some of the people think that once you go for a spiritual cleansing, it means you have aligned, you're fully aligned with your spirit. However, that's not the case. Ake sikhulume ngabantwana ke who dream ababa namaphupho la imimoya yabo ibatshela ukuthi sekufanele bahlangane baze bakutshele bathi khuphula amakhosi kuze uzokwazi ukuthi ube into eyodwa nemimoya yakho. Uma abantu abadala bebesho njalo kwena basuke bekhuluma ngeprocess esuke sekufanele uyihambe yokuthi ukwazi ukuthi u-align nemimoya yakho ngesingisi. Uma bekukhulunywa ngomuntu onobungoma suke kukhuluma about ijourney esikufanele uyithathe yentwaso. Okay, it's where la esike sibecacisela khona ukuthi isikhathi sakho kuze ukwazi uku-aligna nedluzi lakho nemimoya yakho sekufanele uthathe istep of intwaso, your initiation process, because kuze ukwazi ukuthi u-aligne nedluzi lakho nemimoya yakho sekufanele uqaleke ijourney yakho yentwaso ke la uzobe usudla khona ke izinkamba okanye amagobongo edlozi usugqoka ngendlela yakhona usufollowisha imithetho yakhona uba phela budla ukudla kwedlozi. Uma ukwi process yentwaso kune step esikufanele usuhamba khona sikuphakamisa imimoya ethize ngesikhathi sakhona nangesikhathi sakhona ngendlela yakhona nge process yakhona. That is your alignment process, right? Uma bo umuntu wemimoya yamanzi, umndawu, umlozi, izinzuza neminye imimoya yamanzi, nakhona kune alignment process yakhona that you undergo in ensuring that you align with your spirits. Ilage phelage uma bo umuntu ke osu thwasiswe yibona ngendlela yabo suke sekufike kwisigaba ke sokuthi uyiphothule leyo moya. Abanye baye bathi ke ukubarula umndawo ngokwenye indlela, abanye bakubiza ngeindlela ehlukile, kudependa on your culture ukuthi ibizwa kanjani. But that is your alignment process. That is the process leyo, leso sigaba leso sokufika kusona sokuthi fanele u-align nemoya yakho nakhona neindlela zakhona ye process yakhona. Osuke khona usu initiator inzuza, usu initiator umndawo wakho nayo yonke imoya yakhona. That is the alignment process. Esuke usuku usufanele usufike kulelo zinga kuleso sigaba in that stage. So uma usuvezelwa imimoya yakho ukuthi sekufike leso sikhathi, basuke bekhuluma ke ngeprocess esikufanele uyiqale uyenze ukuze uzokwazi ukuthi uxhumane nemoya yakho, ukuze uzokwazi ukuthi u-align nemoya yakho. On the other hand, a spiritual cleansing ila khona mhlambe usadukile ngokwelamoya kusakhona izinto ongakaziqondi kahle, kusakhona mhlambe isigaba lout awukakazazi kahle kahle ukuthi iyiphi lemimoya ekumbathile, or awukakazadli kahle kahle ukuthi iyiphi lemimoya ekusuke kufanele uyikhuphule. So when you're going for a spiritual cleansing, it assists you ukuthi iphakamise imimoya yakho ukuthi ikwazi ukuthi is reveal, especially laba bathi gogo I don't even know ukuthi imiphi imimoya engimbathile, kodwa ziningi izindlela amaphupho imicabango yonke into idlozi lakhe lisuke communicate ngalo abasuke sebekuvezela ukuthi kunesiphiwo onaso. So when you're going for a spiritual cleansing, it assists you in opening up izinto eziningi le esuke fanele khona kuphele iconfusion in your life, kuphele la ukuthi ungazi understand ukuthi what is it that you need to do in order ukuthi align nemimoya yakho. So e spiritual cleansing it assists you there ukuthi ukwazi ukuthi umbuleleke kwelamoya ukuthi imiphi imoya kwembathile, imiphi imimoya ene power in your life. Iyiphi le dlozi okanye imimoya ekwembathile, siphi lesi sithunywa esikumbathile, usuku subanikeza ukubaphakamisa, ukubavula kahle kahle ukuthi abakumbuleleke about your journey ukuthi fanele kwenzeke kanjani. Right? Usuke sekufanele usuke kuyisixhumaniso sokuthi uthole iclarity ukuthi kwenzakalani ngawe. Bekukhona la kade usuphume khona nawe eceleni in doing your own things, and maybe you have been doing wrong things, not understanding what is it that you need to do. Maybe uhambile wahamba yokubelaphi, wahamba zonke izindlela nazo zonke izigaba, or wahamba izigodlo zabanye abelaphi, whereby you're not getting clarification ukuthi what is it that ekwembathile, yimiphi le mimoya ekuhluphayo okanye le ozalwe nayo. So i cleansing it assist you in that ukuthi idlozi lakho, imimoya yakho imbuleleke ukuthi hayi nakho ekuyikona esikupha kona. Are you a child ekufanele usebenze ngabantu, or are you just a child efike kuvane kuriveleke ukuthi unemimoya hlambe ekusefanele uyiklenze nje ukuze uzokwazi ukuthi ke imimoya yakho ithathe indawo yakho, indawo yayo, sorry, kubona. That is the benefit of a spiritual cleansing, ukuthi uhlale uyilo muntu okwaziyo ukukhonektha nemimoya yakho. So asingabi naleyo confusion ukuthi when you think ukuthi you going or you coming for a spiritual cleansing, and then you think ukuthi sekufinal stage wakho ke lapho usuzo aligna nemimoya yakho. Cha, i cleansing it assist you kulezi zinto lezi singiyibalile. I hope that clarifies a lot ngabantu abaningi, because there's so much of confusion. Abanye they go for cleansing with the hope that in the end they are now aligned with imimoya yabo, and then mhlambe kube khona lo melaphi ozokwenza leyo cleansing, but still ungaziboni ukuthi okay, hayi ngiyenzile cleansing, avulekile amaphupho, I'm having visions and I'm having these dreams, nazo zonke izinye izinto esengiqala ukuzibona. Even when I pray, maybe I'm starting to pray in tongues, maybe I'm starting to pray in a different way. Sengiyaqala manje sengiyabhodla, sengiyaqala manje sengiyazamula. It assists lapho ke i cleansing to open up imimoya. So I hope lokho kuzokwazi ukuthi kunibulelele kwezinye izinto eziningi. Ngoba khumbula ukuthi not all of us we are gifted ukuthi sizolapha abantu. Yebo, abanye mhlambe kuyidingela nje ukuthi ayiklenzele umzimba wakhe kuze kuzokwazi ukuthi imimoya yakhe iphakame ngendlela efuna ukuphakama ngayo. Masi yakumbulela ke ukuthi ubani wena, uphetheni wena, isiphi lesi siphiwo osiphethe empilweni yakho. Giving away clothes as a gifted child. Remember ukuthi as a gifted person unemimoya, umbethwe imimoya. So when you're actually giving away clothes, maybe it can be that you've outgrown those clothes, maybe it's old clothes you no longer need. There are many reasons that people give away clothes. So it depends on your situation. Why is it that you're giving away those clothes? Right. If you are spiritually gifted, this is what you do when you're giving away your clothes. You need to cleanse your clothes. Cleanse how now, and why are you cleansing? You're cleansing because remember ukuthi ingubo bekade igqoko wena inensila yakho, inethunzi lakho. Okay? So for umuntu naye ozokwazi ukuthi aphinde aqoke lezo ingubo ekade zigqoko wena, angasindwa ithunzi wena kade unalo, angasindwa imimoya wena kade unayo. You need to cleanse your clothes. Idlozi lakhe lizokutshela how do you cleanse your clothes. They can tell you. Abanye, it depends on the power of imoya yakho. It depends ngampela ukuthi umbathwa abantu abanjani. Abanye, they will say, no, you can just wash them off with a washing powder. Abanye, they'll say, no, you need to cleanse it by the river. Go by the river and cleanse them. Or abanye bazothi, no, just use sea water, or noma ngabe manzi, maphi amanzi, sorry, emvelo abasuke bezokutshela ukuthi ukleanse ngayo. They might say put river water and put ashes of impepho yakho You know, ashes where you always pasha ushisimpepo and everything, then might say, take some of those ashes and put it in water and then just cleanse off those clothes to give away. Ngoba manje ususa ithunzi lakho, ususa insila yakho, ususa ubwena, no attachment of you to those clothes. So baningi abantu get that confusion. It's like, gogo mina, I was advised ukuthi if I feel ukuthi I want to give away clothes, I shouldn't give away clothes because that can take away my gift. Rather I burn my clothes. I don't know sabelaphi sinendlela zethu eziningi zokwenza, but mina personally nginemimoya that are giving. So I cannot burn something that someone else might need, might be in desperate need for that. Baningi abantu la ngaphandle who don't have clothes. Let's talk about, I have clothes of abantwana. Maybe they've outgrown those clothes. So kunabantu laba ngaphandla abanabantwana abangaqoki lutho who need clothes. So how would I feel if I'm burning those clothes knowing very well that there might be people who are in desperate need for those clothes? So I give them away for donation or ngazi zone zonke indlela engisuke ngingakwazi ukuthi ngiphisane ngayo lezi ngubo. But before I do that, I always cleanse the clothes that I give away. Shoes nas noma ngabe yini le engisuke ngiyenza, and I choose also who I give those clothes to. So nalapho ke just be careful. Lalela imimoya yakho, listen to your spirit ukuthi bathi what is it that you need to do with your clothes if you feel that you want to give it away. Because abanye bethu we really have good hearts, and we are singabantu who don't just throw away things, who don't just burn things just like that. So rather uma bufisa ukudonate maybe to a certain organization, maybe to somewhere where you feel ukuthi, you know what, I really feel like I need to give away. Kuneyindawo where you go and take clothes that you no longer need and toys and zonke lezo zinto and give it to that place. So you can do that as well, but cleanse your clothes before you do anything, so that nomuntu, as I've said before, ozobe thola iy'ngubo zakho angazitholi esecindezelwe imimoya yakho, ngoba yena I may not be gifted as you. So uzosigcine sezizwe khathala yonke le, because manje uhleli uyithunzi lakho ngoba wena awuzange uzuyi cleanse off iy'ngubo zakho. And two, khumbula phela ukuthi sometimes siyagqoka, abanye bethu we are not cleansed. We might be spiritually gifted, but we are not cleansed. Mhlawumbe sinezichitho, sinamathunzi amabi amnyama asuke namathele kuthini. So imagine ke that person receiving those clothes aphinde mase ezowelelela, you know, i-curse yakho ongazange wena uzuyi-cleanse. So it's very important when you're giving away clothes, giving away izinto nje usuke feel ukuthi you just want to go and donate, just cleanse it off. Be careful. Abathakathi do disguise themselves to be someone you know, someone you trust. What am I saying when I'm saying this? Sometimes you get those dreams, those convincing dreams. You dream of someone you know. It can be your partner, your best friend, your brother, your sister, a family member that you are close to, your child for that matter sometimes, your mother, your father, you dream of them doing izinto as if something bad to you, you know. You dream of them benza izinto mhlambe kudlisa izinto as snacks, akudlisi ukudla okunempethu, akudlise, you know, all those dreams that show isichitho, that show isilwane mhlambe ubaphuphe bekushadisa nento ethize eyisilwane. You understand that? There's a lot of dreams that comes with that. So one day I will touch on the dreams that show you ukuthi yini isichitho kulelo phupho abasuke bekuvezela kona, yini le abasuke bekuganisa nesilwane, bekushadisa nesilwane, yini le abasuke bekufakela idliso, in all of those things. So all of those dreams, and only to find in the dream that maybe umuntu omaziyo who's giving you something or is doing something that you've feel uncomfortable obonayo ukuthi angiyithandi lento ayenzayo, right? And then kulobo buso balowo muntu ubone lo muntu omthandayo okanye umkhonzile okanye lo osuke usondelene naye, and then wena ucabange ukuthi shuthi vele uyangithakatha lo muntu. It's not always the case. Kunempande esetshenziswa abathakathi la abasuke bethi bekuhlanganisa leyo mpande mase bekubiza, it's either uyakhafula noma ukubiza ekuhambeni noma ungabe ukuthakatha ngayiphi indlela afike yasho ukuthi uyazicashisa yena ngomuntu othize osukusondelene naye wena and then wena uzobe usuphupha lo muntu. So every time when you have dreams like that, just khuleka and listen to intuition yakho ukuthi ithini kuwena. Is it really that person or umuntu osuke yifihla ngalowo muntu engafuni ukuthi ubone wena ukuthi ubani okugangayo ubani okuthakathayo. And ibono dlozi elinamandla nginixoxele liyakwazi ukuthi leyo mpane lowo muthi leyo lujike in the dream uthi uyambuka umuntu ebusweni okay nangu ubani mhlambi partner yakho okanye it's your sibling or your mother noma ngabe ubani umbona the same time they are changing in their face and it's becoming someone else. It's becoming someone else, probably maybe omaziyo. Trust your instinct there. The second person ose shintsha into that form uyena ke umuntu suke ekade ganga ngoba basuke bekuphendulela befuna bephendula lo muntu akusebenzisele wona wena ucabanga ukuthi ugangwa yilotha kwathi ayilo kanti uye so bunedloze elinamandla eliphakeme elisebenzayo empilweni yakho liyamembula same time in your dream you get that confusion ukuthi oh bekukade kubani in the dream enginikeza ukudla kunezimpethu or kanye nginika ukudla engifunda ngenkani then suddenly ubuso bakhe bashintsha an example kwabo ugogo waka next door or umama waka next door or suddenly kwashintsha kwabo best friend yami. Be careful of those dreams. Idlozi liyakhuluma in most of the time. It's just that some of us do not understand ngendlela abasuke besivezela ngayo izinto. So always when you wake up ukadube namaphupho anjalo, it's very important ukuthi hlala phansi ulalele imimoya yakho, listen to intuition yakho, hlala phansi ukhuleke, ucele iguidance, ucele ukuthi bakumbulele ukuthi lisho ukuthini leli phupho. Ngabe lo muntu uyanganga yini? Okanye kuvezwa enye into. Just be careful of that because abathakathi hayi bayayisebenzisa izimpande zokuyifihla ukuthi ungaboni ukuthi ubani. Akuqhathe uze uzonde umuntu umzondela kanti akakwenzi lutho. Yabona? So just listen to intuition after you have such dreams. The importance of cleansing amanono and doing iladi for them. We're talking about abantwana asebadlule emhlabeni. Whether waba is still born, whether they were born abantwana washona ziningi indlela esilahlekelwa ngazo abantwana abagcine sebeba idlozi lomnono. So ngicela nje just to touch on ama points ambalwa the importance of ukumcleansa umnono nokumenzela ilati because ezinye izinto lezi abantu abasuke bengibuza ngazo. Remember ukuthi kwi video oqala part 1 I did mention ukuthi le video le I'm doing based on ama questions nama scenarios enzeka kubantu and basuke bengicela for clarity and izinto eziningi because ba confused okunye baduke kakhulu in terms of endaweni iningi abayihambile bengalithola usizo beyibona repeatedly belokhu bebhekane nesimo esisodwa. So if sikhuluma about the importance of ukuhlambulula umntwana owadlula emhlabeni kubalekile kakhulu because khumbula ukuthi lo mphefumulo umntwana wakho nawo owahamba owadlula akusho ukuthi just because physically akekho kuwena ukuthi ukwazi ukuthi umnakekele ukwazi ukuthi umbheke umtreat like a child njengoba sinabantwana. So akufanele naye umneglect kufanele kuhambe ikhathi la ukwazi khona ukuthi umenzela umsebenzi ladi nje lokuthi umnakekele umgeze umhlambulule umenzela iladi umphakele umtshengisa ukuthi noma ngabe akazange azalwe okanye noma ngabe wahamba singakafika isikhathi sakhe noma ngabe isiphi isimo esamenza ukuthi angaphili ngokwenyama mutshengisa ukuthi usamthanda njengomntwana wakho angaboni usufocus kakhulu kubantwana abaphilayo ezibona yena eseneglected. So kubalekile ukuthi umnake lo mntwana. Abanye futhi ukuthi mhlambe abe ne miscarriage mhlambe kube stillborn and then akushiye kanjalo lokho isimo esikanjalo fanele usihlambulule lowo moya ngoba awuhambanga ngakahle, if I may put it that way. It was not a natural situation indlela ahamba ngayo. Ziningi izinto eziyaye zibe nembangela yokuthi umntwana ahambe ngalokho. Okunye, abanye bethu siyaba abort abantwana, uyenze into ngenhloso. Okunye kuwukuthi kube iphutha. Okunye kuwukuthi ubungazi, it's all that you are pregnant. Ziningi indlela eyisuke zithatha abantwana. So nalabo abasuke bazi impelanga ukuthi abhothile umntwana, usezibona izinto zakhe empilweni ayisahambi kahle, uma behambe yohlola lapha nalapha bamtshele ukuthi hayi, wena kunomntwana owamkhipha okanye umntwana owaphuphuma kuwena, ohlele useyithunzi elibi kuwena ngoba awuzange uzumhlambulule. So kuma situations akanjalo, lo mntwana uyaye angahlali kahle vele kuwena ngoba akazange azaphile ngendlela efanele. Ake ngikhulume nje ngomuntu abhothile. Akazange azaphile umntwana, wena wathatha i-choice yakho ukuthi uende impilo yakhe. UNkulunkulu wamupha wakupha a life, and then wena ngawakha ama reasons you decided ukuthi lo mphefumulo uqede ngawo. Wangalithola yini ithuba lakhe lokuphila. So lo mntwana vele uzoba umntwana ongezi kahle kuwena, aze with the anger ukuthi why wenza isimo esikanje, why ungamnikazanga yena ithuba lakhe lokuphila emhlabeni. Angiphathi ke be ukuthi mhlawumbe usunomunye umntwana okanye unabanye abantwana. Uhlupha ngisho nalabo bantwana labo osukusunabo ngoba uya ngokuba nesikhwele ukuthi laba bona ubavumele kanjani ukuthi baphile kwe Elsiena wawuqeda owakhe umphefumulo. Mase ke ejika esephenduka eba umntwana osehleli kabi empilweni zenu. Akuvalela imali, akuvalela izinto, ngisho abantwana bakho bagule njalo, nibone nje izinto zingekho kahle. Njoba ngisho uhamba uhlola wenze konke utshela uthi hayi, kunomntwana onesimo kanje kanje ekufanele umhlambulule. So to avoid ukuthi kuze kufike kuma situation la umntwana esegcine sekuvalela khona izinto zakho, if you have aborted a child, mukleanze lo umntwana, umenzele iseremoni ladi lokuxolisa, lokushweleza ukuthi waphucwa impilo yakhe, wanganikezwa ithuba lokuphila. Mase uyamstatela izizathu ukuthi kungani wakwenza lokho wakwenza. Uma ngabe kwaba yiphutha, mutshele ukuthi kwakuyiphutha, akuzange kuze kube inhloso yakho. Bekuthi wawungazi ukuthi ukhulelwe nakhona. Muchazele ukuthi cha, wawungazi ukuthi umthwele kuwena kwase kwenzeka lesi simo, uyaxolisa ubungazi. Ziningi izinto ekusuke sekufanele umbuleleke, because into engafuneki ukuthi uma buzokwenza umsebenzi weladi la usuke uzoxhumana khona nabangasekho, and you lie ama reasons akho, you lie or ungastate my reasons whatsoever, uvele nje wenze lo msebenzi uthi ngiyaniphakela njengoba wadlula emhlabeni. Asikhulume nje nalo osuke abhothile okanye obengazi ukuthi ukhulelwe. Muchazele lo mntwana, because lelo ladi lakho ozolenza, it will be in vain, because lo mntwana ufuna i-explanation, ufuna i-apology ukuthi why yena engaphilanga, why ungamnikezanga ithuba washeshe wathathwa emhlabeni, wangalithola i-opportunity naye ukuthi akhule nabanye abantwana, azoyiphilele yakhe impilo naye masekhulile. So nabanye abantwana mhlawumpe uyabona ukuthi hayi, labantwana bona ubanakekela, uyabathanda, ubenzela zonke izinto, kodwa yena why? Ngoba manje naye wakhiwa kuwena, waphiwa yena, wena uphiwa uNkulunkulu nezidalwa zakhe bakupha lo mntwana, kodwa impilo yakhe yasheshe yanqamula. So kubalulekile kakhulu ukuthi uma buzokwenza iladi lomnono la usuke umhlambulula khona, uthi ngicela ukugeza ke, ngigeza ke indlela owahamba ngayo, ngikuhlambulula ukuthi ukwazi ukuthi ke uhlalisane nabadala, ube idlozi elihle empilweni yami, ube idlozi elihle emndenini wethu, kuze sikwazi ukuthi siqhubeke sikunake njengomntwana, njengelunga lalomndeni. Uchaze isimo sakho ukuthi ke isenzo esenzakala ukuthi uze ugcine uphucwa impilo yakho kwenzeka lokhu nalokhu 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 ushweleze ngendlela usholeza ngayo nalelo ladi lakho there are important things ekusuke kufanele zibe khona lapho bekuwukuthi lo mntwana wawungakaze umqambe igama yila uzobe usumqamba khona igama ke sekukhona nezingubo ke esuke sezikhona osuku sumgqokisa zona usumbathisa zona I do not want to go deep ukuthi iceremony on doing iladi lomnono or ukushweleza kumnono how do you go about doing it because indlela zabantu azifani zokwenza so angifuni ukukhuluma indlela masikuba khona oyigcekayo mina I only teach on what I've been told ngitshelwa yeyami imimoya nangendlela asebengenzisa ngayo izinto and abantu bengibenzisile izinto zabo ngaleyo ndlela ziyaphumelela so iprocess leyo umuntu mase ukuthi uyayenza I can give guidance on how to do it mase kuthiwa uyayenza kodwa it's very important ungawuyekeleli lowo moya loyo ngoba uzolokhu uhleli nje umoya omubi empilweni yakho mase uzibona ngathi wena uthakathiwe zonke lezo zinto kanti cha ile yamphefumulo ongalitholanga ithuba lokuthi aphile naye yakhe impilo ngendlela befisa ukuthi aphile ngayo okanye naye wayomntwana owayizoba isibusiso ephiwe isiphiwo esithize empilweni yakho yakhe sorry abezoletha usizo lukhulu empilweni yakho ngithi yabona ngezathu zakho ke ithize wa decide ukuthi umntwana umphuce lelo thuba eseligcine kuvaleleka ithuba elalizo benefita nawe futhi in the end ngoba ngisho usuwenza lelo ladi lelo izinto zobuyiphethe kulelo lathi ukudla nazo zonke izinto ungabe phela usubhekelela umntwana kuphela uma buwenza ukushweleza kumnono include nabogogo laba ayikuyibona owathi umntwana ekhishwa bamthatha bamnakekela fanele buxolise ushweleza uxolise nakogogo nomkhulu laba ekuyibona abakuthathela umntwana bakukhulisela umntwana so it's important also ukuthi whatever items that you have kulelo ladi also include ogogo nomkhulu even kwindlela yakho yokukhuluma ba include nabo usho ukuthi ngiyaxolisa bogogo nomkhulu isenze ngasenza ngaleyo ndlela leyo zobubika ngayo kodwa nje kubalulekile ukuthi buwenza umsebenzi womnono buwenza ukushweleza kumnono yiladi noma ngabe ukushweleza ngayiphi indlela umnono akahambi yedwa bafake ogogo nomkhulu kuleyo conversation yakho kulolo xolo lakho sukulicela nezinto sukuyiphethe osukuzobaphakela khona bafake nabo ogogo nomkhulu ungabashiyi ngaphandle stay blessed everyone and ngithemba ukuthi this video was very informative nizinakekele ngaso sonke isikhathi bayethe